After last year's nightmare of a season, Chad Weenan's 2012 has been the stuff that dreams are made of. So far, he's been perfect, winning all four motos on the year. Can he keep that streak alive today in Maryland? Our nation's capital for Racer TV's coverage of the 2012 AMA Pro ATV Motocross Championship. There's your series points leader, Chad Weenan, here signing autographs, as well as Thomas Brown and the Balance Racing Moto Experts Yamaha. Yeah, the pits are open for business, so you can get up close and personal with the best riders in the world before they go racing. What a race we have set today. Chad Weenan has won every moto so far this year. But John Natale, your defending champion on the Can-Am, has been right there on his rear wheels the entire way. We are set for a big clash between those two. And of course, you cannot count out a veteran like Joe Bird, multi-time champion of the series. Brown is going to be in the mix, as well as a youngster named Joel Hetrick, who's been very fast in qualifying. Should be a great race, but before we get racing, let's check in on the Baldwin Racing Honda team. There's Mark Baldwin himself right there. He's delivered many championships in this series with his old buddy Tim Farr. Now it's on the shoulders of Josh Upperman to try to deliver a number one.
I got into racing ATVs. My uncle was, he was just a motorhead, liked to ride and go fast on stuff. And it was always fun watching him go through the fields and stuff. And I got on a bike and I was pretty good, decent, and he was like, you know what, you should go to a local race around here and you know, see what you could do. And 2006 and 7, I ran for with Tim Farr under his team, and huge influence on that guy. I mean, he's a brilliant guy, a mentor of mine. I mean, helps me out still today with a lot of things, bike testing and everything. I'm here because I love to do what I do, and it's fun, exhilarating, and it's a great time. The people around here, you guys, everybody around here is so friendly and awesome and nice, and it's just a nice environment to come and enjoy your time and to do what you love to do. You know, last year I did come close to winning the championship. It was came down to the last race, last moto, and everything. You know, it's definitely fun, exhilarating, and all that stuff. I know what I need to do. I know how I need to train to go that fast. I know a lot more things that I didn't know back then that I do now, and that I'm hungry enough that I do want to get it, and I'm going to try my hardest and everything just to be up front and win that championship.
We'll keep track of the number 20's progress throughout the day. Riders and mechanics heading down to the starting line area. We are ready to get Moto 1 going. We'll run two motos today, combine the scores from both to determine an overall winner. There's Joe Bird, fastest in qualifying today, taking the ATVriders.com Fast Qualifier Award. You've got Goodman and Upperman, who are two lightning quick starters in this one. Natale and Hetrick on the Can-Ams, and then the Yamahas of Weenan and T. Brown. This is going to be a great race. Jason Wygant here to give you the call. 30-second card going to go sideways. We got a helmet cam on Upperman. Let's see how he does. And they're bumping and banging into the first turn, and it looks like that number 20 is indeed out front. Weenan, I believe that's him on the Yamaha, in second, but Josh Upperman, yet another hole shot on that Baldwin Honda. That guy has been nailing in the last couple of years. The question is, does he have the pace and the fitness to hold it all the way to the end and get the win? Weenan, who, as we mentioned, has won every moto so far this year, is already up to second, and I believe that's Joel Hetrick, the sophomore, up to third on the Can-Am, and looking to make moves on Weenan, as looks like Upperman has actually pulled away a bit early on. He definitely has some speed today. This track known. A lot of uphills, a lot of downhills. Upperman goes off the track. Upperman makes a mistake, and Weenan is going to take the lead from him. Just when it looked like Upperman was about to put some distance between himself and second place, he now falls into third as Hetrick down Henry Hill makes a move on Upperman as well. Hedrick not done. He's going after Weenan for the number one spot here at the beginning of lap two. And Upperman got to be feeling what happened. One quick mistake and he goes back to third. And when you give Chad Weenan the lead, it's really hard to stop him because he has speed to burn. With an open track, this guy could do some real damage. Although Hedrick, who is a multi-time champion on youth ATVs and in the amateur ranks, there's no doubt he has the talent. A lot of people bill him as a star of the future. Is today the day that Hedrick shows he's got the stuff to beat anyone in the world? He's definitely got the speed going so far. He's staying right there behind Weenan. And they've distanced themselves now a bit from third place Upperman. With Natale, your defending champ, up to fourth. This track pretty darn rough. Natale had said he was looking for rougher tracks than we had at the first two rounds. He thought today would be one of those tracks. We'll see if he can make tracks and catch our leaders. Racer TV is brought to you by Can-Am and by AMSOIL. We're back at Buds Creek Raceway, the Triangle Cycles ATV National. Chad Weenan and Joel Hedrick trying to get away from your third place rider, Josh Upperman. Look how rough this track. Oh, John Natale is off the track and stuck. Your defending series champ, who was second in points coming into this race and said this was the type of course he could get a win on, is way back now. But it is in the hands of his Can-Am teammate, Hedrick, who's in second to go for the win. He's got Chad Weenan right in front of him. The MotoWorks Can-Am team, their hopes now lie on that number 88. Weenan getting maximum distance off of that big uphill table, and he's able to pull away just a little bit from Hedrick there. Weenan, a big, strong guy, is as aggressive as they come. He likes the rough tracks and the big whoop sections as well. And right now, beginning to pull away just a little bit from Hedrick in his second pro season, has already lit it up. Shows he's got the speed to run with anyone. They have pulled away a bit from Upperman, who is now under fire from Brown. Then you've got Bird coming through. And no sign of Natale. As we go back to the leader, Weenan, who's going to pull up more points in the series if he can get this moto win. You see the distance he has now pulled over Hedrick. But in this type of racing, it's always a matter of if, not when. You cannot count anything as an official result until they cross the checkered flag. Even though Weenan has won the first couple of motos this year, he started seasons off very, very strong in the past also. And it seems like he always gets snake bit when it comes to the championship. So these riders know you've got to try to keep the pressure on and then take advantage if the opportunity presents itself. Going out there and just whipping the 44 straight up, not easy to do. He's got incredible speed and talent, and he's aggressive if you want to battle with him. And right now, Hedrick is learning that. He had a little pressure applied early in this race, and Weenan was able to respond. He's actually been able to pull away just a little bit. The lead is not huge. I'd say it's about 4.5, maybe 5 seconds right now, but it's going to allow him to breathe a little bit easier. But if you're Hedrick, you know it's a long championship dance. You've got to be there all the way to the end. Battle brewing for third. It looks like Brown has caught Upperman. So we've got the Honda against the Yamaha, and look at the big leap downhill for T. Brown. That inside line with that roller isn't going to work as far as making the pass, but now Upperman knows he is there, and this has been Upperman's trouble the last few years. The starts have been incredible. He's gotten some wins. He's had some strong podium finishes, but too often he turns those first place starts into third or fourth place finishes. You know he wants to go wire to wire in these things. And once again, here he is in third, trying to hold on to that last podium position. Weenan now putting the hammer down, looking to go 5 for 5 on moto wins this year, undefeated so far. And this might be his strongest performance yet. Now on the right side of the track, I believe Hedrick and Weenan have just put Natale a lap down. So obviously something is wrong. I don't know if it was a mechanical glitch in the chassis or suspension that put him off the track, or there was a mechanical problem as a result of going off the track. But either way, Weenan, Hedrick, and the rest of these riders are going to make up huge points on the man from Warriors Mark, Pennsylvania, who's running the number one plate as your defending champ. But again, we mentioned it before, Weenan has been snake bit in these races in the past. He knows how quickly the fortunes can change. You just got to keep the momentum going as long as you can. Doing a great job right now. Actually overjumped, though, that tabletop. Had a big, hard landing. But the man from Galena, Illinois, able to shrug that off. Didn't even lose that much ground despite the mistake. And he is headed toward another moto win. Although credit to the 88 Hetrick, the young kid keeping the veteran in his sights. It's over. Another win for Weenan. Hetrick, his best race so far this season, finishes in second. And the battle is still raging for third between Upperman and Brown. Brown going to try that inside line one last time. Runs out of time. Upperman takes the podium position. Brown takes second. Those are your results. We'll be back with more from Moto2 next. Racer TV is brought to you by Can-Am and by AMSOIL. Pretty cool deal this year in the AMA ATV Motocross Series. Riders have been attending sessions at local elementary schools, kind of give back and talk about riding safely to all the kids out there that also, of course, are interested in ATVs. This weekend, we had John Atelli there in the middle, Thomas Brown on the left, and on the right, Chad Weenan signing autographs, demonstrating safety gear, and letting the fans know what ATV racing is all about. Ready for Moto2 here at Bud's Creek. It's the TriangleCycles.com ATV National, just about 45 minutes outside of Washington, D.C. There's John Atelli, had a rough one in Moto1, wants to bounce back in Moto2. His young teammate Joel Hetrick finished second in that race, and Chad Weenan was the winner. Weenan has yet to lose a moto this year, but they've been close pretty much every time. We'll see if someone can finally end the number 44's win streak here at Bud's Creek. Who's going to win the drag race into Turn 1? No surprise, it's Upperman again. The Baldwin Motorsports Honda is out front and hoping to make it last. Remember, he was leading the Moto 1 like this, and then he went off the track. Here, an immediate attack by Wynn and goes into the number one spot. Just two corners into this race, and the fans got to be loving that kind of action. Not messing around is Wynn, and now airing out perfectly that table. We saw him overjump it a couple times in the first moto. He's got this track wired, and look at the gap. He's already pulled over Upperman and the rest of the field. Weenan, like a cannon off the start here. Joe Bird up to the number two spot. He has gotten around Upperman as well. Upperman has had the starts, but I'm sure he's not happy about giving up the lead early like this. And now you have Natale and Hetrick flying their MotoWorks Can-Ams in formation. There's Bird, there's Upperman, there is Natale trying to go for the number three spot, trying to get around Upperman. Natale lost a ton of points in Moto1. After an off-track excursion, he was able to rally for sixth, but he's not going to be happy about that. He wants to take Weenan down and end this win streak. No love lost between Natale and Weenan. They were once teammates at Can-Am. They had a couple of aggressive run-ins despite that, and now the gloves are off because they're riding for different teams. And Weenan's lead, it looks like the number seven of Bird has begun to cut into it. So Weenan was flying on the first couple of laps. Now here comes Bird, by far Bird's best moto of the year. And we've seen this happen before. Bird starts the year off a little bit off the pace, but then he catches fire. And boy, has he ever here at Bud's Creek. Bird was a solid fifth in moto number one, now going for the lead in moto number two. And not sure what happened to Ween, and he has not been the same rider after the first couple of laps. Meanwhile, got the Can-Ams on attack, trying to go after Upperman for third. Natale and Hetrick, and it looks like Thomas Brown on the T. Brown Moto Experts Yamaha is right there as well. Back to the leaders. Weenan continues to deal with pressure from Bird, and this group is not that far back. You've got a four-pack, Bird, Natale, Hetrick, and Brown, who can watch this battle for the lead. That leaves six riders in sight of the number one spot. Weenan still has it. He knows where the good lines are on this racetrack. He was able to withstand some heat from Hetrick throughout much of the first moto, so he can shut the doors every time Bird tries to kick it down. Time clicking off. It looks like Weenan has maybe stabilized that lead for a minute. Nothing is stabilized with this battle. Look at this. Different lines everywhere. Hetrick trying to jump to the inside of his teammate Natale, while Natale goes all the way up the right side of the track to find a smooth line and go after Upperman. Then Natale went to the left, and I think he was able to make that pass as Berg closes back in on Weenan. Almost too much action to call here from Buds Creek. Can Weenan hold off Bird, and can Bird hold off everyone else? This is going to be an exciting race to the finish. Stay with us. Racer TV is brought to you by Can-Am and by AMSOIL. It's not over yet here at Buds Creek. Jason Wygant giving you the call. The later laps here of the Buds Creek National brought to you by Triangle Cycles. Chad Weenan in blue in the lead. The red machine of Joe Bird putting the charge on in the number two position. It has been close between these two riders for much of the way. Just past the halfway point now. Can Bird keep the heat on? It actually looks like Weenan has pulled away a little bit. And I'll tell you what, if Bird can't put the fight to Weenan, Natale's not going to wait around. He'll try to do it. And he leaps over to the outside now, to the inside, and makes the pass on Bird. A little look over from Bird. That's aggressive racing, and Hetrick going to follow him through. Hetrick trying to get around Bird, and Natale opened the door, and his teammate went right by. Brown now right behind, and Upperman there as well. Natale's not done. He wants to go after Weenan, and he can see him in the longer sections of the track. And he's closing the gap with Hetrick right there as well. It looks like totally different lines starting to come together now for Natale. He's on the inside when everyone's on the outside and vice versa. It worked. It allowed him to get by Bird quickly, and it has allowed him to close right up on his championship rival and go for the lead. And take it! No, side by side they battle. Weenan not going to give it to him. Weenan's going to be the inside for this big, long, sweeping section. Can he take advantage of that? Natale on the outside not going to lift. They bump wheels. And Natale comes out with the number one spot. Unbelievable from about fourth to first. That's why they call John Natale the Iron Man. He does not give up. He keeps digging down deep. And if Weenan isn't careful, Natale's young teammate Hetrick is going to go to the number two spot. And if he does, well, I wouldn't count Hetrick out of going for the number one position. Here it is, Hetrick trying to get around Weenan. Now, it's not a battle for the overall right now. Weenan would still win this one with a 1-3. Hetrick's able to make the pass on him. This is huge. Weenan has yet to lose a moto all year, and in the course of about a lap, he has been zapped by both of the MotoWorks Can-Ams. Natale now trying to pull away. Who's got the fitness down the stretch? No doubt that Natale and Hetrick both went to the red zone there to make up the kind of ground they had to make up on the leaders, Bird and Weenan, and then get by them. Who is stronger now between the two of them on the stretch run as Thomas Brown has caught and passed Weenan? Not sure what has happened to your series points leader. He has come unraveled here in a big way. And that fourth place position opens the door, I believe, for Hetrick to take the overall with 2-2 scores. The 2-2 would edge Weenan, who is looking at a 1-4 right now. Not sure what happened in the big man from Illinois, but not only is his moto win streak over, but his overall win streak with it. And Natale, whatever points he lost in Moto 1, he's about to get a whole heaping helping of them back here in Moto 2, and he does it the hard way. Didn't get the start. He said if he was on a rough track, he knew he could win. Well, that's the type of track he got today, and he used not only his aggression and his strength, but his experience. He found the good lines when this track got rough late in the Moto, and there are no challengers left for the Ironman. Natale, who finished last year with a broken arm and still managed to get through the finale to clinch the championship. He worked so hard to get it, so hard to develop this Can-Am DS450. You know he's not going to give it up without a fight. And after that tough first moto, a fight is what he had here in moto number two. He put the fight to them, and no one could stop him. John Natale wins the moto, but just as big, Joel Hetrick is going to win the overall with a pair of second-place finishes. Thomas Brown takes third, and Chad Weenan, something went wrong in the latter portion of this race that'll hold him to fourth in the moto and second overall in the day. Upperman, not what he wanted with a pair of hole shots, ends up in fifth in the moto. Riders now on the podium getting to celebrate with the fans and thank the sponsors that got them there. A very tired but happy John Natale with the moto win, but Joel Hetrick takes the overall with 2-2 scores. Let's talk to a very happy young winner.
My first win of the season was great. Came out with a 2-2, got their overall. Got second time qualifying too, and it's just really, really good feeling. All these fans out here makes it even better, cheering me on, and just all my friends and family come out to watch. It's awesome. The track was so gnarly today, but you know, I pushed through it and got the win, and I can't be any happier.
The word is that Weenan tweaked his wrist while leading that moto, and that's what dropped him back. Basically a dead heat on points for he and Natale today. Hetrick right behind Upperman for fourth. The Hetrick name is synonymous with youth and mini ATV racing, now making their mark in the pro class. Big congrats out to him, and we expect more great racing the next time the AMA ATV Motocross Series hooks up. For everyone here, I'm Jason Wygant. Thanks for watching.